Yes. So like this, that you have to create the plots, scatter plots and all this, okay, line plots or whatever it is. For example, if you want to, okay, plot the multiple plots on one single graph. So already that we discussed in the matplot, the same thing that we can do here also. But if you want to work on that, okay, then we have to use, that is observe here. So showing the multiple relationships with, by using FACETS, okay, FACETS is one of the function that we are having. We are going to work with that. Let us start working. Yes. So let us start that. Okay, SNS replot that I'm going to work with the mileage, price, and then kind that I want line. Otherwise, if you want scatter, let us mention scatter. Otherwise, not required. By default, it is scatter. And then based on the transmission, and then I want, whenever if you want the different, let us take COL equals to model. Let us take the data. So these are all the extraordinary extra things that if you want, you can work on that. Otherwise, not required. Let us observe this. So observe here. So whatever the different COL model that we are taking here, it is going to, okay, based on that, it is SEL cars, SEL model with the combination of these price, mileage, and transmission. Right? So like this, that you can work with the subplots, okay, model equal to SC with the combination of price, mileage, and the transmission. So it is represented like this. For example, if you are, so it depends on the data categorical, that how much, how many values that you are having, that it is going to spread. Otherwise, if I take that year is having so many values, right? So 2011, 2012 like this, so and so, it will take a lot of parts. So it is not visualizing, it is not fitting actually. So like this, let us take the color of the cars, color. So like this. Right? Otherwise that you can take it, okay, what, how much of this graph that you can represent, that how much of height that you required, how much of length, width, and everything that you can take here. Right? So color it is. Otherwise, if I take the model also. I want different style on the model. At that time, it will represent more number of plots, right? So, but it is not fit here. So at that time, it is better to mention some length, width from your side. So I am taking that how much of heights that you require. Color on everything, color wrap, all these are there, right? Color wrap is there. That color wrap that I'm going to take some color wraps, different 5. And height, how many rows that you required. And expect some values. And length, line width, how much line width that you required. Line width, for example, I want 3 or 2, some, let us take something. And the kind, let us take the kind equals to, now let us represent with the line. Let us execute it. It is good. Yes. Is it clear? So depends on the length, that how much that you are taking, based on that, that can work. So the, so whatever that we present, that we work, that it is entirely C, x-axis and y-axis, that entirely it is going to, it is the, based on the values only, the numerical values only that we worked here, not on the categorical. At the time of taking the third variable or fourth variable, that we categorize the data with the categorical data. But the mainly that we concentrate, the mainly that we are taking this x-axis and y-axis on the numerical data only, right? So whenever if you want to work on the categorical data, so at that time we are having so many, okay, plottings like If you want to check the categorical distribution plot, then box plot is there, violent plot is there, right? So like this, we are having so many plots. Point plot is there, count plot is there. So different visualizations. So it takes a lot of time to discuss all these plots and to discuss. So already we discussed the box plot, right? How the data it is distributed, where it is started, where it is ended, what is the quantiles in that. So those type of visualizations in advanced level that you can do with the combination of different variables here, right? So YLAN, YLAN is also one of the representation. So multiple charts, multiple group frequencies of data that you can observe in the different forms. So I will do one thing. I will share the material to you. Nearly it is having more than 100 pages of content. It is about the seaborn. So if I discuss this, seaborn like one by one function, one by one argument takes nearly, even if you take 10 classes also, it is not complete. That much of content that we are having here in this seaborn. So the entire content that I will share to you, whatever that we are going to do by using seaborn, let us practice from your side. So let us observe that what is the content it is. Right. So let us observe it. It is nearly, it is having, 123 pages it is. Total 123 pages content it is. What is seaborn? What are the key features? How to install? What are the libraries that we have to import? How to import the data sets? So these are all the contents that we are going to observe here. Seaborn plotting functions, how to work on the scatter plots, how to work on the scatter plots, line plots, phase, have to work on the categorical data, how to observe the distributions of this categorical data. So different forms, what is univariate, bivariate distributions, how to work on the linear relationships. Next, multi-plot grids, if you want the multiple plots, how to work on that. So this is comes under low-level plotting if you want to change the axis, figures, styles, colors, So different, like this, you can work on that. So entirely it is having 123, once observe this, lot of information that it is having. Seaborn is one of the advanced graphical representation. Why? Because it is not like a matplotlib, simple like a matplotlib. Here it is having so many arguments in each function with the different features it is. So based on the practice only that you'll get. So already that we worked, right? So there we are working on fMRI, one of the data set. So which is available in the seaborn. So like this, by taking the different styles and dashes and markers and so. So all these things that we discussed with the IRIS, not IRIS, user course data set. So let us practice from your side, by taking all these. They created some of the dummy data and also they worked on that. So whenever if you want to plot the multiple based on the COL like this, how to work on the categorical data, box plot. So whenever you are going to work with the box plot, then box plot is the function that we have to use. Kind equal, by default, the kind it is box. Right? See, just now we work with the numerical data. If you want to work with the numerical data, what is the function that we use? Relational plot, RAL plot. The same thing that if you want to work on the categorical data, let us use the cat plot. Actually, box plot is also used. However, that we use the scatter plots. So the same thing that we use this kind equal to scatter in the relational plot, right? Same way in the place of working with this box plot, that kind that you can specify here, kind equal to box. By default, it is box plot only. So like this, that you can work here. Right? So categorical data, point plot, so many plots are there at the time of working with the categorical. So this is one type of categorical scatter plots it is. So categorical means all the data, similar group of data is one side. So how the data it is represented, let us observe here. See, scatter plots, the same thing. Depends on the third variable, whether gender it is male or female, so. The same thing that with the horizontal. box plots, one of the important concepts. Okay, don't leave this box plot. Mainly, we are going to concentrate on this box plot only. Why? Because this box plot mainly depends on the statistics, okay, in very depth, that how the data it is distributed. Whether the data is in the left or right, or okay, what is the difference between the mean, median, what are the outliers that it is having, how to find these outliers, okay. So, all these that you can observe here. This is the box and plot. Violin plots is also very important. Here it is going to show, we're having a lot of analysis in this. What is this dot? What is this black? Why it is like this? Same like box plot, only with the different shapes. Right? See, violin. Bar plots. So everything that you can work on the, okay, categorical plot, CAT, cat plot only. Wide form data, violin plot. So like that, it is nearly 123 pages of content. It takes a lot of time to practice for you also. It is not possible or 1 or 2 days. Let us utilize these weekends and then let us practice all this. Right. So this is about today's session. Okay. That we completed the graphical representation. Already we learned a lot of things in this graphical representation. How to visualize the data by using a graphics package, which belongs to R programming, by using GR devices package, which belongs to R programming, matplotlib, which belongs to Python, seaborn, which belongs to Python. Okay, Bouquet is there. It is also one of the package which belongs to Python that you can, okay, that if you want, you can learn. So like this, okay, we are can visualize the data in different ways, different formats. But here in this Python and R programming language, that we are having comfortable libraries to work on this data visualization, and also it is very easy to work here. So for visualization, no need to use any other third party tool like reporting services, SSRS, like Power BI, which belongs to Microsoft, like some other reporting tools like Tableau. So these are all the things not be required. So that is the tool there we are going to do by using drag and dropping and so. But the same thing, better than that, okay, that we can do in this seaborn, in these graphics devices, okay, GR devices, so. Why? Because this nowadays we are having which is supportable, comfortable graphical packages with the updatable versions. So whatever that we are working present, the seaborn and graphics, these are all the updatable versions. These are having more features than the third party tools, right? On the existing last 2-3 years back, that we are going to take the support of a third party tool like a Tableau or Power BI or some other tool, okay, for doing the data visualization. Present, we don't require any other data tool, okay. The project's entirely is going to works on the data visualization, okay, by using R and Python only. R is one of the powerful tool for the data visualization. Why? Because for the intention of the graphical representations only, data analysis only, they develop the R programming. And we are having a lot of libraries like a Matplot, seaborn, Bouquet. So these are all the different packages that we are having which work on the data visualization. Yes. So this is about data visualization. So I will share this content to you. Let us practice. Let us practice from your side. Right? Yes. Thank you.